When I know the little strength, I'll call you and tell me to dynamic.
What's up, Jerry?
I'm good.
That's what they have to
do. Yeah, that's what they have to do.
Presentation, handing over ceremony with the Delices, Toloma Women in Action Group. Delice. And then at the head table we have with us the Honorable Intercession, Minister of Education, and also Parliamentary Representative for Delice. That's my constituency as well. Honorable Johnson Drago, Minister of Agriculture and Fisheries. And we have the first Van der Beeren, the Dominican National Council of Women, President, part of the group. And we have with us also the Chairman of the Delice Village Council.
Chairman is
here,
but I'm representing the council.
Representative of the council. Okay. So Mr. Etienne is representing the council of Delice. So Delice is very well represented. And then also the media. Thank you very much for coming. So we will get right into it. I will ask Mr. Ken Coppell to give a little overview of the raison d'etre that we are here today, and then we will move on from there.
Thank you very much. Let me start by extending season greetings to one and all. All right. We recognize in the head table first, the Honorable Minister of Agriculture and Fisheries, Mr. Drago. The Honourable Minister responsible for education, as well as the parliamentary representative for the community that we're dealing with today, Delices. The chair of this session, Permanent Secretary in Agriculture and Fisheries, Mr. Gist, and the President of the Dominican National Council of Women, Ms. Vanya David. Also want to recognize Mr. Michael Etienne, representing the local government or the Delice community. And most important, I also want to recognize the women from Delice, the women belonging to the Toloma Women Action Group. I also want to recognize the media, but in a special way, Ms. Petra Schillingford. She has assisted me quite a bit in getting this thing organized today. From IICA has gone beyond its mandate. Our mandate is really in terms of providing technical cooperation and support in the area of agriculture as well as rural development. However, we have worked with a number of groups through, in particular when it relates to women, the Dominican National Council of Women. We have been working with different groups, and the Toloma Women in Action is one group we have worked with in advancing the development of the agricultural sector. Since the passage of Tropical Storm Erika, we all know the devastation that the storm did, both in terms of our lives, our livelihood, and very interestingly, the agricultural sector. So we have joined the rest in making a contribution towards the restoration. However, we need to recognize IICA is not a humanitarian aid agency, but headquarters for raising funds among the IICA staff throughout the hemisphere. We were able to raise some resources to put towards helping the Toloma Women in Action Group in restoring the activity as it relates to livelihood. We raised just over $16,000 and we put it towards the purchase of inputs to include fertilizers, seeds, a small piece of machinery, this is a mist blower, pesticides to help persons get back as quickly as possible in the production of their livelihood. We know that Toloma is a critical, very important crop to the area, but we also know that people do their backyard gardens in terms of vegetables, so we try to deal with both. So today, on behalf of the Director General of IICA, Dr. Victor Villalobos, the Director of Management Integration, Diego Montenegro, the IICA representative, which is Mr. John King, and the extended IICA family, we are pleased to be able to make this contribution towards the supporting of the Toloma Women in Action Group. So at this point, I also want to make mention that IICA is also involved from its technical cooperation program for approval of a rapid response action. We will be extending support to the ministry and other beneficiaries in relation to restoration activities. So our rapid response action is part of our technical cooperation program. It will run for 6 months. We will be looking at other areas, for instance, building resilience in agriculture by developing adaptation plans, helping to build resilience among farmers holdings, especially crops and small stocks. And we're hoping that we can promote some best practices to ensure that farmers adopt practices that will build resilience as it relates to the commodity or the venture that they're involved in. And most of the work will start next year, but we have already started the procurement of certain basic infrastructure. For instance, we want to multiply and propagate things like vetiver grass so persons can start planting grass along the contours. And in doing so, we're looking at establishing nurseries and so on. So we are also involved, not from a humanitarian aid standpoint, but from our technical cooperation program to advance the development of to build resilience among the various subsectors in agriculture. On that note, I'd like to thank you all, and we hope the Delice group great Christmas, and hope that come 2016 they will be back on their feet in terms of the agricultural ventures. Thanks again.
President of the Dominican National Congress of Women, say a few remarks.
Thank you. Good morning to all members of the head table. Special thanks to Petra for always coming across for us whenever we deal or have to deal with rural women and assisting in arranging whatever plans and programs to follow. Good morning again. Following the passage of Tropical Storm Erika, the Dominican National Council of Women, in its plight to assist the women and their family, have seek assistance around locally, regionally, and internationally to put the women and families who have directly and indirectly suffered through the tropical storm back on a rampage. As women, we do not believe in staying stagnant. We want to be always on the move. And so the Dominican National Council of Women, through seeking assistance, approached some local, regional, and international organizations and institutions. And IICA, being a longtime partner of the Dominican National Council of Women, was one of those that we approached. thus far, we can say we have had some very good response, locally and otherwise, including the assistance of DAIC and ISA Trading, which we have sought some funding. We want to say to IICA today, thank you for coming on board, as they have always done with the women on the island. IICA have assisted the northeast, the east, and the south with east women in collaboration with the Ministry of Agriculture, extension officers, and the NCW. We have worked as a team for a couple years. And so this initiative is no exception. We want to thank the family of IICA when we approach them from the Dominican National Council of Women standpoint, that they were more than willing to go forward to assist us. As Mr. Coppel said to us, we do not do humanitarian service. However, I said, Mr. Coppel, you have been there in technical assistance, and so I believe this is no exception. You can still go forward for us. We at the Dominican National Council of Women were thrilled when we got the response from IICA Dominica to say that the family of IICA in the region have responded positively to assisting the Toloma Women in Action. And so today, I am very grateful to see a few members here with us. The Toloma Women in Action have been around, struggling for at least 7 years. And this year, they have been either directly or indirectly affected, their water, their farms, and otherwise. So I am pleased to see that IICA, in its rapid response, have come forward and assisted us in getting the women some inputs to get them back on their feet. I want to say thank you to Mr. Coppel and his team, and we look forward to that continued relationship as we partner on the agriculture movement with the rural women island-wide. Thank you.
So just to do some brief remarks with regards to your feelings, the feelings of your group, as to what this is handed over this
one. Okay. On behalf of the Toloma Women group, I want to thank IICA and all the other institutions that have come forward to assist us in such a time as this. We are very grateful for the support that you have given, and I want to assure you that we will put what you have given to us into good use. Once again, I want to thank personally Mr. Coppel, because he is always at the forefront, even though it is not in the devastation business. He's always at the forefront, always informing what we are doing. And especially in a time like this, he truly remembered us. So I want to just say thank you, IICA, thank you, Mr. Coppel, for such a great gesture.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, PS. I will try to keep it short and sweet. Kiss. First of all, let me recognize the presence here this morning. Honorable Johnson Drago, Minister for Agriculture. The Permanent Secretary, Mr. Gist. I thought I said good morning.
Good morning.
Let me just briefly say that, for me, this is another opportune moment that the hard work, the tenacity of the industry of the women of Delice in the Delice Toloma Women in Action group is one more time paying off dividends. I say this because following the demise of the banana industry, Delice was one of the first communities that took the whole issue of diversification very seriously. But for most other communities in Dominica, this thrust was led by the male segment of society. But in Delice, we saw a number of women coming together, or although I've been advised there are at least two men. But a group of women, 28 women, came together and recognizing that they needed to find a way of generating income to sustain their families and communities, they got together and engaged themselves in the production of Toloma. Later on, they also recognized the need that just primary production was not sufficient. And so they got into actually processing the product. And they have distinguished themselves not only locally, nationally, but also regionally, because their product has hit the regional market. And of course, we anticipate within the coming year, the international market. I say this because agriculture still remains one of the key pillars for our nation's development. But importantly, agro-processing must be viewed seriously by all those involved in the agriculture industry. And that is why I believe that the Delice Toloma Women in Action has taken this thing one notch further. I want to really thank IICA for recognizing the industry of this group of women. I want to thank the Dominican National Council of Women for working with this group and for recognizing that following the passage of Tropical Storm Erika, that Delice, the communities of Delice, Boudica, were really adversely impacted to the extent that while we speak here, they still had to go down the gorge to get into Ruzu. Although thankfully, by the end of this week, this will be a thing of the past. But let me say thanks to you for the recognition that this group of women has truly taken the issue of sustenance of their families seriously. And I can only wish that you will continue for many more decades so that the DEU, Delice Toloma Women in Action, will not just be a household name here in Dominica or the region, but that on the global market, we will be able to travel to China and Australia, Austria and Germany, and see the product on the shelves out there. Again, let me say thank you to you, and I must say to these, my ladies, this is your first shot at the Christmas, and I expect that there will be much more to follow. Thank you very much, and God bless.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister. Moving right along, I would like to invite Honorable Minister Jonathan Drive, Minister of Agriculture and Fisheries, to give a few remarks to you as well. Honorable Drive.
Thank you very much, Special Way, my colleague, the Minister of Education, Human Resource Development, and the Parliamentary Representative for Delice. Let me say that it's really a joy for me to be here this morning to be part of this ceremony. We told the farming community of Dominica that the government and its supporting agency will do everything within our limits to assist our farmers in moving forward. This morning we are happy that IICA is making this presentation to the Delice Toloma Women's Association group. And what's most important is that it's a contribution from the staff of IICA for the region. As Mr. Coppell said, it's not part of their response to Tropical Storm Erika coming from IICA as an institution, but rather it's a contribution from the collective effort of all the staff of IICA. And for this, we want to say to them, thank you very much. We want you, Mr. Popel, to convey our thanks to your colleagues in the region. And to let them know that not only the Delice women appreciate their effort, but the entire country is highly appreciative. I want to say to the Delice women organization that I've been following you for all these, even before I got into the Ministry of Agriculture. I remember visiting Venezuela with Miss Sorrendo. The women were already in action. I want to say to you that we appreciate the effort that you've been making to assist each other. I want to say to the farming community of women in Dominica that we must use the Delice structure as a model. One of the new initiative being pursued not only by IICA but other regional agricultural structures is the importance of family farming. Because in order to make it on the global market, we cannot continue to operate as small entities. Even within our own structure in Dominica, we are encouraging groups to be formed across the island. In every community, we need to have a farmers group, well-structured, working with the zones, the extension within the area. I want to say to the women farmers community, farming community of Dominica, that they must establish groups, women groups in other areas. It would be nice if we could have a strong vegetable farmers group of women coming from the valley. We are preparing to start a women group of farmers concentrating on cassava and potatoes in the Kudu San Sofapiti area, because we have quite a bit of women in cassava in that area. Government will be able to assist these groups better if they are well structured. I'm not talking about cooperatives. I'm talking about farmers group with an executive where they meet and they discuss their challenges. I want to say to the farming community of Dominica that coming out of Erika, the post-Erika period, it's we are looking at doing things better. So I want all of our farmers to go to the extension offices within their zones and use the wealth of knowledge that exists within the structures. Invite the extensions to your farms, because everybody is presently on a rapid replanting program. You cannot do it alone. You need the support of the extension officers of your area. So do not wait on them to come to you. Go to the offices and invite them to your farms so that you can get the technical support you need to move forward. Because in every area in the agricultural sector, we must increase production. We must increase our yields on the farm. And you can only do that if you get the right technical support that you need. Government will continue to play its part, but you have a responsibility in your capacity as the farmer to ensure that you maximize production coming out of your farm. Today, you will receive knapsacks and chemicals and Miss Blue and also vegetable seeds to assist you with your production in Delice. I know you will do very well with it. I have that confidence that you will do very well. But whilst we're here, I need to also additionally state to our white potato farmers that we have received presently 1,175 bags of white potato seeds. In immediately after Erika, we had a presentation right here where Propel made a contribution to the farming sector of potato seeds. They are here. My understanding is that they are moving rapidly. And remember, we told you it was the elite, high-quality seeds that we have. So we're looking for a very good crop of white potato in 2016. So farmers can come to the gardens and purchase their white potato seeds. I have been informed by the extension that the farmers, they can go ahead and plant immediately. As soon as they purchase their seeds, they can go ahead and plant immediately. So this is good news for the farming sector. Also, this week, we will be assisting our fishers, fisher folks. Government has approved $300,000 to assist fishermen who were affected by Tropical Storm Erika. Our hope is that before the week is over, we can start paying this contribution to some of these farmers to get them back into the waters. In 2016, a number of programs will unfold, both from what government contribution and from our supporting agency. But today, we are here to celebrate with the Toloma farmers of Delice. Let me wish the Toloma farmers of Delice a very Merry Christmas. Let me wish all of the farming community in Dominica a very, very Merry Christmas and a productive 2016, not only to the farmers of Dominica, but to all the hardworking people of Dominica in the different sectors. Let 2016 be a bumper year for us in all our undertakings. Thank you very much.
Handing over. Yes, so we're just going to be handing over by. Is it by
Jimmy's over? Yeah, man. They gotta take some seats as well.
Yeah.
Take him down. Yeah. Alright. Oh, yeah, we're going to have a seat. Let's get out of the seat. Let's get out of the
Well, we have a big eco family. We will actually need a little token in terms of the restoration after Tropical Storm Erika. So I hope you receive this in terms of our contribution and good faith.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I'm here with Mr. Kent Coppell. He is a technical specialist at IICA. And just a while ago, we witnessed IICA donating to the Toloma Women's Group of Delice a number of items that